Good morning, one and all. Welcome to the Python programming workshop. Today, we will see if else if statements in Python. It is also called as branching statement, decision making statement, or conditional statement. So, let's start. If else statements in any language is called as control statements or decision making statements. In real life, when we need to make some decisions and based on these decisions, we decide what should we do next. Similar situation arises in programming also, where we need to make some decisions and based on these decisions, we will execute the next block of code. Decision making statements in programming languages decides the direction of flow of program execution. Decision making statements or control statements, or it is also called as branching statements, available in Python also. There are four different types of branching statements in Python. First one is if statement, second one if else statement, third one nested if statement, and fourth one if else if ladder. Okay, so why we called as this statement as a branching statements? Because there are multiple conditions. Depending on multiple conditions, only one block of code is executed, not all the blocks of code. Like the branch, if a tree having four branches, in that only one branch get executed and other branches are skipped one. That is why these if else statements are called as branching statements. Okay, so let's move to the next part. So first type of statement, that is if statement. If statement is the most simple decision making statement. It is used to decide whether a certain statement or block of statements will be executed or not based on certain condition. So first, what is the syntax of the if statement? So syntax is similar to all other languages, C++, Java, C#, but some changes must be there, which is if then gives the condition block. Their parentheses are optional. After that, condition gives the colon, then gives the indentation, and then gives body of if. No need to write curly bracket. Instead of curly bracket, we have to use indentation. Okay, so if here the condition is true, then and then only body of if get executed. Otherwise, body does not get executed. Okay, so what is indentation? Indentation is the main part in the Python language, which decides the scope of the statement. So Python relies on indentation. That is, what is indentation? White spaces at the beginning of the line. So white spaces, what is white space characters? Tab, spacebar, enter, backspace, all these are the white space characters. So how many white spaces we required or space bar we required? One space, two space. Okay, if one body, if same block of body structure, it is same number of white spaces are required. Otherwise, it gives you syntax errors in Python. Other programming languages for that indentation, mostly curly brackets are used. Okay, so let's move on some program. Suppose A is equal to 21, B is equal to 31, then give the condition if A greater than B, no indentation is given, and print A is max. If the condition is true, what is the body of if? Print A is max, but there is no indentation. So that statement gives you error. Okay, so what is the error? Error class or exception class is indentation error. And what is the error message? Expected an indentation block. Okay, Guys, we will see this code on the PyCharm IDE. So PyCharm IDE, create one new file. Okay, not new file. What we want to create? New Python file. So new Python file, click on that, give the name as a demo and press enter key. So it creates new demo.py. Now what we have to do? We have to write the code. Suppose A is equal to 21, B is equal to 31, then if, what is the syntax? If keyword, then condition. What is the condition? A greater than B, this is the condition. After that condition gives colon, that is most important part. No need to write parenthesis, but colon after the condition is necessary. After that, if you don't give indentation and print, what you have to print? Print in bracket what? A is max. Okay, so guys, this is our code. Okay, so what is the code? A is equal to 21, B is equal to 31, and if A is greater than B. Okay, so let's take max value, that is 121. Okay, so this condition must be true. 121 greater than 31, yes, condition is true. So true then executes the body of if. But what happens? We don't give the indentation. So run it. Okay, so after running, what it gives you? It gives you indentation error, expected an indented block. So that is in runtime environment does not decide what is the scope of this print statement, within the if body or outside the if body of if. So for that purpose we have to give indentation, means number of spaces. You can give one space, it works. You can give four spaces tab, it also works. Okay, so let's move and run it. Run demo. So what happens? Oh yes, what is the output? A is max. That means we got the correct output. Guys, remember, in Python language some syntax are different. Condition, no need to write parenthesis, these are optional. If you write the parenthesis, that is rounded brackets, no problem. And then after condition, colon must be there. If you don't give colon, then also there is a red mark that indicates that it is a syntactical error. So it gives syntactical error, syntax error, invalid syntax. Like this, you know that here something is missing, so you can give the colon here. Understood, guys? Okay, so this is all about indentation and syntax of if, condition. Okay, let's move on next part, that is indentation error, expected an indented block. Next, take another one example of if statement. What is the, take any number from the user. Okay, so take input method, use input method, take the any number. You can use slash n also. Slash n means new line. Okay, then convert this input method return string. So convert that string into integer and save into the num variable. Now check whether this num mod of 2 is equal to 0. If it is 0, then that number is even number, print number is even. Else, okay, we can see it only using if block two times. If num mod of 2 not equal to 0, then what happens, guys? Print number is odd. So that is the program, find number is even or odd using only if statements. Okay, so let's check on our ID. So how to check it? So I'm removing this code, delete it. So for first, num is equal to typecast first initially, int method, then what is the method? Input. You can pass input, enter any number, then slash n, you can give the slash n also, it works. No need to write semicolon at the end of the statement. After that, you have to check if num mod of 2 is equal to 0. Yes, if it is equal to, give colon after the if. Then if it is, print number is even. Next, else. Okay, no use of else. Again use if num mod of 2 not equal to 0, give colon here, then print number is odd. Yes guys, yeah. Okay, so run it and check whether it works or not. Run demo. Enter any number. Suppose I am entering 11. So 11 is entered at the next line. Why? Because of slash n. Cursor goes to the next line. 11. So what is 11? Number is odd. So what is the output? Number is odd. So using same if statement two times, you have to execute and check whether the number is even or odd. But guys, listen. If there is no indentation, then it gives you syntactical error. So tab must be there. Now, one more important. If block, upper if block having 4 spaces and next if block having 1 space, suppose. Is it works? Yes. It gives you any syntactical error? Yes. No. There is no syntactical error. 22. What is the 22? Number is even. So, for two different blocks, the statements inside that block, you can have that statement having same number of spaces, that is the same number of intended spaces. But if two blocks are different, then number of spaces differs. Yeah, then no problem. But guys, listen, if this statement, if having some indentation and suppose printf, is it works? Yeah, check whether it works or no. Okay, enter the number. Suppose enter odd number. So what is the odd number? 21 is an odd number. Oh yeah, it does not give any message. Why? Because this second if is inside the if statement. That means it is nested if. So if this condition is true, then only inner block get executed. That means this if is inside the body of outer if statement. So that is the beauty of indentation. So this if and this if, both first if, that is first if and next if, that is having on the same intent, same level, then and then only. Print and print, they having some here 4 spaces, 8 spaces, no problem, it works properly. Just run and check. 22, yes, number is even. That means it works. Understood, guys? Yes. Let's move on to the next point. So next branching statement is if else statements. If else statement alone tells us if a condition is true, then if block is executed. Otherwise, else block must execute. Means in if else statement, either if get executed or else get executed, but not both at a time. So what is the syntax? What is the syntax? If condition colon body of if, execute if block if the condition is true, else body of else, execute the else block if the condition is false. Okay, so take one example. Same example, take the number from the user. Check whether this, that is number mod of 2 is equal to 0. Means if it is 0, that means number is even, else number is odd. Here in previous if statements, we need to write two conditions, but if else statement, no need to write two conditions. So if else performance is more better than that of the use of if statements multiple time. So let's execute this if else on
our PyCharm IDE. So same problem statement, take the number from user, then check if mod of 2 is equal to 0, print number is even, else. So instead of if, what we want to do, we want to use else, but after else give the colon and print number is odd. So guys, just check, run demo, enter any number, 21, so 20 number, 21 is odd, number is odd. So this is all about if else statement. No need to write parenthesis also, parenthesis is also optional. Great. So parenthesis is also optional, but colon after condition is must. So this is all about if else statement. If condition is true, then and then only if body get executed. If condition is false, then automatically cursor goes to the next block, that is else block, and else block must be executed. So it choose between if or else block, that is branching. So these statements, if else statements, are also called as branching statements. Okay, so move on to the next point, nested if else statement. Nested if else statements means an if statement inside another if statement, that is called as nested if statement. Either if else is inside if or if else is inside else part, both works. So let's check what is the syntax. What is the syntax? If condition 1, body of outer if, then inside if, inner if, outer if, there is inner if, condition 2, then body of inner if, else, colon, body of inner else, then else, body of outer else. This is the syntax. That means if and else, inside this if and else, again you can write if else inside if block, or you can write it inside else block also. So guys, this is the syntax. Okay, check whether what is problem statement. So today we will see, enter 3 numbers from user and find max number between that 3 numbers. Okay, so first take 3 numbers from the user using input method. Take one, enter number A, number B, and enter number C. So find which number is max, either A, B, or C. For that purpose, what we have to do, first we have to check when A is max. If when A is max, okay, so decide the condition. So what is the condition? A is max if A is greater than B and A is greater than C, then and then only. That means A is greater than B and A is greater than C, then and then only. Which one is the max? A is the max. So directly print A is the max. Next, else, otherwise. Otherwise, which one is the max? B or C? We don't know. So for that purpose, again we check if B is greater than C, then B is max. Or else, if otherwise, if this condition is false, then automatically C is max. But here 3 different branches are there. Out of that, only one get executed at a time. Either A is max, B is max, and C is max. Here we have considered that A, B, C are 3 different values, not same values. Understood, guys? So let's check whether it works or not. Okay, we can directly take this program. Don't want to write it. Okay, so first I will give the comment triple, then triple single quotes. It is a multi-line comment, guys. Okay, so this is the problem statement. So what is the problem statement? Take 3 numbers from the user, A, B, C, you can take it differently or you can take into same statement using split method, dot split. You can use dot split method and you can take A, B, C in the single statement also. Okay, let's, after that, must decide when A is max. This is the most important part. When A is max, when A is greater than B and A is greater than C, then and then only A is max. Okay. Next, if else otherwise B or C get is max. But if B is greater than C, then B is max. Otherwise, C is max. These are called as nested if else statement. That means it is a branching statement actually. So guys, run this program. Okay. So there is first number, suppose 22, second number 11, and third number 55. So which one is the max? C, number C is max. So what is the output? C is max. That is the expected output. Understood? What is the next state? If else statement. Either if else is inside if statement, outer if statement, or if else is inside else statement, outer else statement. So that is all about nested if else. I hope you are enjoying watching this video. If you have any problem, let me know and write the query in comment box or chat box. Guys, let's move on next part. Next type of branching statement is if else if ladder. All other languages it is called as if else if, but in Python the notation is different. Simple if and else, se is not there, l if is there. So if a user can decide among multiple condition, then use if else if ladder. If conditions are more, 10, 20, 30, 5, 6, like this, then better to use if if ladder instead of nested or if else. Understood? So if conditions are more in your problem statements, then always use if else ladder. Okay, so guys, move on to the next point. If any condition is true in this ladder, then statement associated with that if or else if or if is executed and the rest of the ladder is bypassed, like similar to other languages. If none of the condition is true, then the final else statement will be executed. So check what is the syntax. Syntax is if condition then statement, else if condition then statements. You can use else if conditions 2, 3, 4, 5, no limit for that. And last is the else part. You must know indentation and as well as colon after the condition or else part. Okay, so this is all about syntax and when to use if else ladder in Python. So take one program. What is the program? You have to print the grade A, B, C like this or fail. Marks between 80 to 81 shows the grade A. Similarly, 80 to 61 grade B and 60 to 41 grade C. And if below 40, then fail like this. So what is the? So first take the input from the user using input method. Enter your marks. Convert it into int data type, then save into one variable marks, then check if marks are greater than 80 and marks are less than equal to 100, that is marks between 100 to 81. If this condition is true, then print congrats, you have scored grade A. Else if SE is not there, just pronounce it as L if. Then in condition marks greater than 60 and marks less than equal to 80, then print, you have scored grade B. Similarly, L if marks greater than 40 and marks less than equal to 60, then print, you have scored grade C. Else, last statement, else, sorry, you are fail. Like this, you can execute the programs having multiple conditions, because this program having first condition, second, fourth, third and last one. So these are the multiple condition problem statement. So better to use if, if, else ladder. You can also solve this same problem statement using simple if else or nested if else. But better performance is given by if, else ladder. Okay, I think you understood. Now it's time to execute your program using PyCharm. So if else if ladder. Okay, so this is our program. Take the marks, check the marks between which range, and if it is that particular range, then you can print the particular message and print exit at the end. So right click, run your program. Okay, so first enter the marks. Suppose I will enter the 60 marks. Okay, so 60, is it between 60 to 40? That means what is the expected output? You have scored grade C and last exit. So let's check. Okay, so what is the output? You have scored grade C and exit. That means our code executes properly. Similar way, you can take number of problem statement which is based on if else if ladder. For example, take any day value from the user 1 to 7 and depending on that print the day name. What is first, if user enters 1, then day is Monday. If user enters 2, then day is Tuesday, like this. Or there are number of other problem statements also. Take the month number from the user and depending on the month number, print the how many days are in that month. So similar types of problems having multiple conditions, that is month is equal to 1, month is equal to 2, or month is equal to 12. Like this, multiple conditions are there. So at that time, better to use if else if ladders. That means if conditions are more, then use if else if ladder. Understood, guys? Okay, hope you understand it better. Okay, so thank you. If you have any doubts, then let me know and write the query in condition box. Okay, so guys, today we will stop here.